Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we'll be taking addition and subtraction of fraction. As you can see on the screen, we have some questions here. So let's dive straight into solving the question. So start with question number one. We have 3/7 plus 2/7. So let's say solutions. Solution number one now. Now, in fraction, generally, in fraction, if you are solving any fraction, either you are adding or you are subtracting, the moment the fraction has the same denominator, you don't have to worry yourself too much. All you just need to do is to pick the denominator that is common and use the operation that you have for the numerator. So let's take a template here. Let's get this template here. Awesome. So with this, we have the same denominator, 7. So you have bring out the 7 that you have here. So you work with the operation you have here, 3 + 2. That's the operation that you have at the numerator, 3 + 2. Awesome. So with this, you can now say your 3 + 2 is what? It's 5. Let's get this template down here. 3 + 2 here is what? It's 5. So that's the final answer. Because they're having the same denominator, just bring it out and operate with the operation you have at the numerator. So for question number two, (9/10 - 3/10). Awesome. So with this, let's just take this template to be useful for us. The same principle, because we have the same denominator. Just bring out one. The same denominator, just bring out one and operate with the operation you have here. 9 - 3. 9 - 3. So with this, very easy. Let's get this template here. So 9 - 3 will give us what? 6. Awesome. 6/10. But recall that in our previous classes, you can go back to watch our video on fraction in its lowest term. The moment they can cut, you do what? You cut them. Don't leave it that way. This ought to be our answer, but because they can cut, look at 6 and 10, something can cut. You can use 2 to divide both the numerator and the denominator. If you cut the numerator with 2, you'll be left with 3. And if you divide the denominator with 2, make sure you are dividing both the numerator and the denominator with the same number. 2 here, 2 in 6, give us 3, and 2 in 10, give us 5. Make sure you are dividing both the numerator and the denominator with the same number. So we'll be left with what? 3/5. That will be our final answer. 3/5. You can go back to watch our video on how to divide or make fraction in its lowest term. So for question number 3, 2/9 + 4/5. For question number 3, awesome. So with this, now, This is a little bit different because let's get this template here. We don't have the same denominator this time around. We don't have the same what? Denominator. So what are we going to do? You can watch our video on LCM. Just check our channel on LCM. How to look for LCM. So now if you don't have the same denominator, what you need to do is to look for the LCM of 9 and 5. Let's see, if you look for the LCM, if you solve for the LCM of 9, you get 45. Very good. So how many times will 9 go in 45? That's 5 times. 5 times 2 will give you 10. Let me come again. How many times will 9 go in 45? 5 times. That 5 and these 2 that you have here, that's 10, plus this operation that you have here. So, how many times will 5 go in 45? 9 times. Very key. You understand that. You don't have to make mistake. If you now say 9 times 4, it will give you 36. Awesome. So we're almost there. Let's get this template down here. So you see 10 plus 36, that will give you 46. The denominator divided by the denominator, which is what? 45. You can leave your answer like this, but looking at it, this is an improper fraction. Your answer is still correct like this, but you can still change it to the mixed fraction. You can watch our previous video on how to convert improper fraction to mixed fraction. So let's quickly do that. How many times will 45 go in 46? That's just once. Let's get that template down here. Just once. You say 45 times 1, give you 45. 46 minus 5, you'll be left with 1. Divided by 45, which is your denominator that you have here. So 1 over 1 over 45 is still the same as 46 over 45. So let's go to question number 4. Six over 7 minus 2 over 5. Question number 4. Awesome. So with this, the same problem we have here. The denominator are not the same. The denominator are not the same. So what do we need to do? We look for the LCM as well. LCM of 7 and 5. You can watch our video on how to look for LCM. LCM of 7 and 5 will give us 5. So how many times will 7 go in 35? That's 5 times. 5 times 6 will give us 30. Awesome. The operation that we have here is minus. How many times will 5 go in 35? That's 7 times. 7 times 2 will give us what? 14. Very good. So if you bring that to a calculator and punch, 30 minus 14 will give you what? 16. Divided by 35 that we have here. Is there any number that can cut at the same time? 16 and 35, no number. So our answer will be 16 over 35. This action is proper fraction. So you can leave it this way. Let's go straight to 5. A little bit different. This one has a mixed fraction. Mixed fraction. So for question number 5, trying to solve as many questions as we can so that we can get a good understanding of how to solve this. Awesome. Now, this one has a mixed fraction. That's a mixed fraction. Let's get this thing useful for us. Now, the same method, we'll solve it using the same principle, but this operation, this whole number that is here, you have to work with it. So let's bring them down here. First thing first, operate with your whole number first. This whole number 2 and this whole number 3, because we have operation here, which is plus. So you now see 2 + 3 to give you 5. So you do 5 here, the whole number. Every other step remains the same. The 3 and 5, you do for the LCM. LCM of 3 and 5 will give you what? 15. So let's go. How many times will 3 go in 15? 5 times. 5 times 1 that we have here is 5. The operation here is plus. How many times will 5 go in this 15? That's 3 times. 3 times 2 will give us what? 3 times this 2 will give us 6. Awesome. So with this, don't forget to bring your own number that you have here, which is 5. Now, 5 + 6 give you what? 11. And your denominator that you have here, which is 15. Awesome. So this is our final answer. Let me call our attention to something. If you are solving an objective question, they can give the answer in mixed fraction like this or an improper fraction. So you know how to convert a mixed fraction to an improper fraction. So you are home and dry. So our answer is 5/11/15. And last question. I'll have the question number 6. Number 6. Awesome. This one also has a mixed fraction. So let's get this template. Same method and procedure. So the whole number first, 6 - 2, give us what? 4. The LCM of 7 and 2 is 14. So how many times will 7 go in 14? That's 2 times. 2 times 6 will give us 12. Minus. Minus that we have. How many times will 2 go in 14? That's 7 times. 7 times 1 will give us what? 7. Awesome. Let's get this thing done here. So we bring this our 4 here. It's very key. That's our whole number. So punch your calculator. 7 - 12 - 7 give us 5. 12 - 7 give us what? 5. We bring our denominator that we have here, which is what? 14. Awesome. So this and this cannot cut. There's no number that I need to cut this. So you leave an answer like this. 4 whole number, 5/14. So you can always pause and rewind this video. Better understanding, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, My Simple Maths, and press the notification bell beside so that you can get the notification of our new video. Thank you.